Well, maybe you know what a deliberative body of Frenchmen is like. The judge and half the court were on their feet in a moment, and all shaking their fists at the prisoner, and all storming and vituperating at once, so that you could hardly hear yourself think. They kept this up several minutes, and because Jones sat untroubled and indifferent, they grew madder and noisier all the time. Once she said, with a fleeting trace of the old-time mischief in her eye and manner, "Prithee, speak one at a time, fair lords, then I will answer all of you." At the end of 3 whole hours of furious debating over the oath, the situation had not changed a jot. The bishop was still requiring an unmodified oath. Joan was refusing for the 20th time to take any except the one which she had herself proposed. There was a physical change apparent, but it was confined to the court and judge. They were hoarse, droopy, exhausted by their long frenzy, and had a sort of haggard look in their faces, poor men, whereas Joan was still placid and reposeful, and did not seem noticeably tired. The noise quieted down. There was a waiting pause of some moments' duration. Then the judge surrendered to the prisoner, and with bitterness in his voice told her to take the oath after her own fashion. Joan sunk at once to her knees, and as she laid her hands upon the Gospels, that big English soldier set free his mind.
"By God, if she were but English, she were not in this place another half a second!"
It was the soldier in him responding to the soldier in her. But what a stinging rebuke it was! What an arraignment of French character and French royalty! Would that he could have uttered just that one phrase in the hearing of Orléans! I know that that grateful city, that adoring city, would have risen to the last man and the last woman, and marched upon Rouen. Some speeches, speeches that shame a man and humble him, burn themselves into the memory and remain there. That one is burned into mine. After Joan had made oath, Cochon asked her her name, and where she was born, and some questions about her family, also what her age was. She answered these. Then he asked her how much education she had.